Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. In the previous video, we learned that our programming to your portal can consist of function and function block. And each function block has an instance DB to save its data. Today, I want to talk about another type of data block in TIA portal called global data block and how to create and use it in our program. So let's get started. As I said, different block structures are available when programming a PLC in TIA portal. These blocks include function, function block, and data block DBs. In this video, we will discuss the data blocks, more especially the global data block. What's a data block? A data block is a memory area that is used to save the values of the parameters that are written during the execution of the PLC program. Unlike the code blocks, a data block includes only variable declarations. It doesn't have any networks or instruction like a function or a function block. Global data blocks, also known as shared data blocks, are globally declared for the whole PLC logic. You can access the values of a global data block from all program blocks in your PLC. Every function, function block, or organization block can read the data from a global data block or can write data to a global DB. This data remains in the data block even after the DB is exited. Let's see how we can create and use a global data block in TIA portal. We can create a global data block the same way we create a function or a function block. The project tree, open program blocks, and double click the add new block. Click the data block DB button and select the type of data block as global. You can assign a number to this DB manually or let TIA to do it automatically. Enter a name for the DB. You can enter all the properties you require under additional information. Hit OK. The new data block is created. You can find it here in the program blocks folder. Let's declare some variables. To do that, click the add new and write the variable name that you want. Then choose the variable data type. Next, we can define a start value for the variables. The start value defines the value that a variable is to take in a data block after the CPU startup. It can be changed by the program codes during the execution. Enter the desired start value in this column. To prevent data loss if the PLC stopped or there was a power failure, we can mark the data as retentive. This data will be stored in a retentive memory area and it will not be reset to the start value. Be careful, values of the retentive tags take the defined start value only after a cold restart. After a warm restart, they retain their values and are not reset to the start value. In a global DB, you can define if a variable can be visible from the HMI tag tables or not. You can also define if this variable can be read or written from the HMI. The default setting for any declared variable in a global DB is that it can be accessed, read, and writable from HMI. If you want to disable this feature for a variable, you can uncheck the accessibility option for that variable. Next, we can mark tags as setpoint. During commissioning, these tags can be initialized online and we don't need to set the CPU to stop mode. It can remain in run. In addition, the current tag values can be transferred as start values to the offline program and saved there. When we run the program, I will show you how all these properties work. Define some other types of tags. Download the program. Click on this glass icon here to monitor the values. We double click on the tags values or right click modify operand, you can change the values. With this icon, you can download the modified blocks without setting the CPU to stop and without affecting the values of already loaded tags. But the possible change is limited. To see how this option works, I'm going to add another variable. Download the change. TL says the DB will be reinitialized with start values. As you see, the values that I changed are reinitialized and initial values are written to the variables. To avoid that, we can activate memory reserve. Confirm the activation. Modify the values. Now define another variable and download the change. This time the download will be consistent. And the values are not really initialized. Be careful, not all the CPUs have this option, and as I said, you can download a limited size of changes. If you right click on DB and open properties, you can see and change the size of the memory reserve for this DB. Next, you can save the actual values of the tags as a snapshot. A new column of snapshots is added to the DB. Snapshot values you can even load again to the program after that you have changed the value whenever you want. Change the values and then click here. The dialog says the actual values will be overwritten by snapshot values. Okay, you see exactly the snapshot values as actual. Alternatively, values from the snapshot can be copied to the start values by clicking the icon here for all values or by clicking the next icon for the set points only. Now the start values are changed and the snapshot values are the new start values. Next option, assume you have changed the values and now you want to load the start values back into the actual values. It can copy all start values to the actual values by clicking this icon or only the set points for the tags whose set points checkbox is selected. Let me change some values. As you see now, all the start values are again the actual values. So with these options, you can change the current value of the variables or make the change back. Alright, we learned how to create a global DB in TL portal, and now we need to have access to the variables that we have created in this DB to use them in our code. There are two different modes of accessing data values in data blocks. Blocks with standard access for all CPUs and blocks with optimized access for just 1200 and 1500 CPUs. To understand the difference, I'm going to create another global data block. D DB2 will be optimized DB and DB30 standard. Inside both data blocks, I declare four variables of data types: Boolean, integer, real, and word. The first thing you will notice is that both data blocks are exactly the same. That's because the standard setting for data blocks when working with 7-1200 or 1500 PLCs is that they are optimized. So we need to change the setting of DB3 to make it a standard block. To change the block access, right-click the block, select the properties, go to the attributes, and disable the optimize block access function. Confirm the following message with OK. Now the standard data block has an additional column called offset. In front of each variable in the offset box, three points are written. This will change once you compile your program. Let's compile and see what happens. The offset is filled with, as you can see, 0, 2, 4, and 8. What's that offset and what do these numbers mean? Let's create another standard block and declare the same four variables, but this time I will change the order of the variables' data types. You see the offset of DB3 and DB4 is different. Why are the offset values different when we change the order of the data types? They are the same data types, just in different order. That's because data blocks with standard access have a fixed structure. When we declare a variable inside standard DB, this variable will be assigned a fixed address within the DB. The address of this variable is shown in the offset column. So what we are seeing inside the offset is the address assigned for each variable. Since the structure of standard data blocks is fixed, data blocks are tailored to word limits. It means that they always occupy one word or multiple of that. This is the reason for the different addressing of the same variables when we change the order of the declaration. So when we declare var1 to be of data type Boolean, all the 16 bits will be occupied by this variable, even though it only needs a 1-bit memory. This is why you see the rest of the area marked red, because it's not used but can no longer be used, so it's the last memory. With var2, the data type integer needs 16 bits, so it is using 2 whole bytes. Same with var4, which is of data type word. With var3, we occupied 4 bytes because it is of data type real. This is why the offset for DB2 is 0, 2, 4, and 8. The same concept is executed for DB4, but because the data type order of the variables is different, the memory representation and the offset will be different. So when you work with the standard DB, you have to be careful. There would be a loss of memory each time with declaring a Boolean variable. Just by writing the symbolic name or address of the variable, you can use the variables in your code. Download the changes. change the value of var1, var2 and var4 are changed. That was creating and using a global data block with standard access. Now, what are optimized DBs? The difference between optimized and standard DBs is that variables inside an optimized data block are not assigned to a fixed address. A symbolic name is given for the variables, and the structure of the data block is not fixed as in the standard data blocks. So there is no memory loss and no change in the addresses when declaring new tags. This becomes really apparent if you use Boolean variables between lots of different data types. So declaring new tags in optimized data blocks will not affect the rest of the tags as they are defined by symbolic names. An important thing is that an optimized data block will not allow you to use addresses when working with the tags defined inside of it. I'm going to write some code in OB1. As you see, absolute addressing is not allowed with an optimized data block, and only symbolic names are allowed. Download the change. Another limitation of optimized data block is that you cannot use memory management instructions like fill or block move. This is because both of those instructions require access to the starting offset and structure of the data, but optimized DB doesn't have offset. I'm going to add a function and call the instruction fill. Use a variable of the optimized DB as the input. As you see, the input is red and TS says that access to the DB from this location is not possible. But with the standard DB, it's okay. Alright, we learned in this video that global DBs allow for efficient data management within your PLC system. You can use a DB with both access types in your program according to your CPU type. In the end, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. Bye!